Good morning, student. In today's lecture, we are going to study about the water vascular system, that is water vascular system in a starfish. This is the continuation of our last video. That in our last video we have dealt about, we were doing or studying the type study, that is starfish under the phylum Echinodermata. Okay, so today we are going to study about the water vascular system. It is also known as the ambulacral system. So water vascular system in Echinodermata is also known as the ambulacral system. Okay, and it is a peculiar to the echinoderms only, and this type of water vascular system is restricted to the echinoderms only, and it is not present in any other animal groups. Okay, did you remember in our last semester we have studied about the water vascular system in porifera? Okay, in that it is a different type of canal system will give rise to a water vascular system. Okay, similarly how the porifera were having a water vascular system, in that way a water vascular system is present in the echinoderms, but here it is very well developed as compared to the porifera. Okay, this system of canals is filled with the fluid consisting of a sea water and a corpuscles, a certain type of corpuscles, and the essential part of the system are madreporite, stone canal, ring canal, radial canal, Tiedemann's bodies, then Pollian vesicle, lateral canal, and the tube feet. Okay, so now we will see in detail this part, like we'll study in the different parts of water vascular system in echinoderms. But in today's topic, we are just focusing on the water vascular system of the starfish. Okay, so similarly the echinoderms, as starfish belongs to the phylum Echinodermata, the general plan work of the water vascular system is seen, that is presence of madreporite, then stone canal, ring canal, radial canal, Tiedemann's body, Pollian vesicle, lateral canals, and the tube feet. Only the arrangement and the is differed as per the species. Okay, so now we will see the madreporite. It is the hard, rounded, and the calcareous plate that will be lying on the aboral surface. It is situated in the interradial position, and the surface of the madreporite will be provided with the number of radiating grooves, or this grooves is also known as the furrows. Okay, and the bottom of this furrows or grooves, there will be a perforated minute pores. Okay, and that's why the presence of this perforated minute pores will resemble the whole plate of the madreporites, looks like a sieve. And each pore now lead into the pore canal, and all the pore canal will merge together to form a collecting canals. Okay, and this collecting canals converge into a small bag like structure called as an ampulla. This ampulla lies beneath the madreporite, and ampulla will further opens into the stone canal. Okay, understood? This is about the madreporite. Now we'll see about the stone canal. The next part of water vascular system, madreporites will lead into the stone canal. The stone canal is in the shape of the S shaped. Okay, and the wall of this canal will be having a series of calcareous rings, and hence the name is said to be a stone. Okay, internally the stone canal is lined with the cilia,
and the movement of this cilia, which will draws the sea water from outside into the canal. Okay, one end of the tube opens to the outside through the madreporite, while the another end will lead the canal into ring canal. Okay. And the lumen of the stone canal is occupied by a ridge with a spirally called lamellae.
Now we'll see a ring canal. In this picture, before going to the ring canal, you can just have a look. This is the typical water stage. Okay. As the starfish contains a 5 arms, there has been a 5. In each arm, there will be a part of the water vascular system will run. First part of the water vascular system is the madreporite, which forms the opening, okay, from where the water enters. So madreporite then leads into the stone canal, and stone canal this structure shows a typical water vascular system in a starfish. Okay, the first part is a madreporite, which forms the opening from where the water enters into the water vascular system. Okay, then it leads into the stone canal. Stone canal will then lead into the ring canal. Okay, and this ring canals will be having a different parts. Like first part is the tegument's body, okay, which will be lying inside the inner surface of the ring canal, and they are 10 in numbers. Whereas after the tegment's body comes the pollen vesicles. These pollen vesicles are lied on the outer surface of the ring canal. It is in the form of a pear shaped, and they are 5 in numbers. Okay, after the pollen vesicles from a ring canal itself give rise to or give off a radial canal on the outer surface. Again, on the outer surface of the ring canal, ring canal will give out a radial canal. From radial canal, there is a lateral canal emerges, and lateral canals will end up into the tube feet. So this is the general plan of water vascular system in starfish. Okay. Next is the ring canal. After the stone canal, there comes a ring canal. Ring canal is a wide pentagonal ring-like vessel which will be lying around the mouth. Okay, then comes the tegument's body. The ring canal gives off interradially from its inner surface 10 small yellowish rounded glandular bodies termed as a tegment's body. In estrus, that is basically in starfish, there are only 9 tegment's body occur. Okay, and the position of the 10th being occupied by a stone canal. Okay, the next is the pollen vesicle. The pollen vesicle emerges from the outer side of the ring canal, and they are 5 pear shaped structure. Okay, they are interradially arranged. These are the thin walled bladder like long and will be long with the narrow neck. Okay, the pollen vesicle serves as a storehouse for the fluid in the water vascular system. Followed by pollen vesicle, there is a radial canals. Radial canals from its outer surface, the ring canal gives off 5 radial canals, one entering each arms. The radial canal runs up to the tip of the arms, and the armed is the end is in the end of each radial canal will terminates into the tentacles. Okay,
then followed by radial canal, there is a lateral canal. The lateral canal from each radial canal gives off many paired lateral canal on both the sides, okay, which will be led to a tube port, or the also known as a podium. Each canal is provided with a valve to prevent backward flow of the fluid into the radial canal. Followed by the lateral canal, there has been a tube foot. The tube foot is a hollow, elastic, thin-walled, closed cylindrical cylinder. It consists of an upper sac-like ampulla, a middle tubular podium, and a terminal disc-like sulcus. Muscle fibers are present in the wall of the ampulla and the podium. The tube feet are capable of greater extension, and when it gets extended, they come out through the ambulacral grooves. So this is about the water vascular system of the starfish. Now we'll see the what are the functions of the water vascular system. The water vascular system has three main functions. In a echinoderms, basically they are locomotion, food capture, and attachment. The locomotion, basically we will focus on the starfish only. Starfish exhibits a creeping movement, okay, it creeps on the tube feet. They can move at the speed of around 15 centimeter per minute. The water vascular system will help in locomotion. The water vascular system set up a hydraulic pressure mechanism which brings about the locomotion in the organism. The direction of the movement, one or two arms are slightly raised from the substratum. The ampulla of the tube feet contracts, then the valves in the lateral canal closes. Thus, the water flows into the podium and the hydraulic pressure within the tube feet will increase. This increase lead to the tube feet elongation in the direction of the movement. Okay. Thus, what happened? The tube feet will be extend forward and here, and they will adhere firmly to the substratum by the help of sucker. After the attachment of the tube feet to the surface of the surface of the substratum with the help of a sucker, the tube feet assumes a vertical posture by pulling the body forward. Okay, thus the podia now again contracts. This causes the flow of water from the podia into the ampulla. This results in a shortening of the tube feet. The suckers are released and the tube feet are raised and move forward to repeat the process. This way, the locomotion of the starfish is carried out. Please, student, just go this part, that the how the locomotion of the starfish occurs, because it is very important. Okay. Then next function is about the food capture. With the help of tube feet and the sucker, the starfish capture the prey. How they will capture the prey? The suckers are used to open, for example, in a mussels. Hence, the starfish are carnivorous and they feed on the shellfish or bivalves. The most mostly, like with the help of suckers, they will open up the shell of the mollusk. Okay, then attachment. The starfish can be attached to the rock or any substrate by the help of the tube feet, and tube feet is supplied or will be having a suckers, and with the help of suckers on the tube feet, they will help in attachment to the substratum. So this is about the water vascular system in a starfish. If you have any question regarding this topic, then please let me know, and it is one of the important topics as an exam point of view. Okay, thank you, students.